Coach Wagger back here, another edition of the Quarantine Chronicles, and we are reviewing pizzas. Remember, a pizza a day keeps the corona away. So today on the docket, Jack's Naturally Rising Crust Pepperoni Pizza. So I'm really looking forward to this one. First reason being, the thing looks phenomenal. Take a look at that sucker. Looks great. You got those nice round pepperonis. It looks crispy on the top. You can see the grease giving it that glistening type of look right there. It looks just freaking glorious. Get a good pepperoni smell right there. So we're getting good signs initially here. I'm also looking forward to this for a couple other reasons. So a few days ago, I reviewed a Jack's pizza. What was it? It was a Jack's Original Thin Crust Supreme. So thin crust versus this is a rising crust, and I gave that thin crust a 6.5. That's a pretty solid score. 6.5, you know, that's to the range of it almost being like a good pizza. It's the decent to upper, it's the upper end decent pizza. So 6.5, a good score for a pizza in that solid range. That was with the thin crust. But I'm really looking forward more to the rising crust. My buddy Ryan says the rising crust are better. And if I recall, I think he's right, because I looked at this picture right here on the package, and it's been a hot minute, but nostalgia sets in because I feel like I used to eat these Jack's pizzas back in high school, fold the suckers over in half, eat them like a pizza taco. I can definitely remember doing that in high school, and I think these are the ones. This looks very familiar, so being that I used to eat them back in high school, I know they were decent pizzas. So I'm really looking forward to the Jack's Rising Crust Pepperoni Pizza here. It says right on that, you know, that little advertisement they have or packaging. They're making it for 60 years. You make a pizza for 60 years, you're doing something right. It's also got that 100% real proud Wisconsin cheese. So Wisconsin, you know, known for the dairy. Got some high quality ingredients. The thing looks good. Got a little bit of nostalgia here. I'm really looking forward to this pizza. Given that nostalgia, we're going to pull up some tunes in the background here as well. Party Rock Anthem. So when I was in high school, Party Rock Anthem was like the jam. So we're going to put that on the background here as I get into this pizza review. So slice and dice time. All right, so we got a cut. Oh, this reminds me, I also found a good meme that I think y'all get a kick out of. So we're in quarantine here, you know, trying to lighten the mood up a little bit. Nice meme I found there. What should I do to improve my health? Buy a bike and cut the carbohydrates. And that's what we're doing. Hey, I eat a pizza every day. Cutting the carbs right here, but go for a walk, you know, an hour walk outside, the weather's decent, or it's not, just bundle up, and you're fine. Eat a pizza day, you're fine, you know? Stay active, you're fine. Eat a pizza day. So we're gonna go here with the Jack's. Hopefully this thing does not destroy my mouth. Top of my mouth is getting a little tender, I'm gonna be honest. Burned my mouth a few times here on these pizza reviews. So we got a pretty good hold up there. I would say this is almost ideal hold up. Just a little bit of bend to it. Undercarriage, all that crispy brown, it's looking good. You know, somebody asked me, with these pizzas, do you put them on the pan into the oven, or do you just put it straight into the oven, no pan? I go no pan. I take it out of the oven, put it on a pan to cut it, but I go no pan. I feel like that gets it crispier. If you leave it on the pan, sometimes it's a little soggy or softer in kind of the crust, but this is looking real good. Take a look at that side right there. It's like a golden buttery color. Looking good. The yellow cheese and the white cheese blending together. The grease on top. The crust holding the sucker together pretty good right there on the edge. It's looking good. This is very hot though. Oh yeah. Gotta watch out pepperoni. You know, pepperoni got like grease in it. Grease is freaking hot. So this thing's warm. It's warm. I think I have the tolerance built up so I don't necessarily burn myself, but it's warm. I can see it right there. They got a little chunk of pepperoni too. So the pepperoni on top and the chunk of pepperoni. It's a double dose of pepperonis. How does it taste? You know, as the song builds right here to like the crescendo, we'll let the anticipation build. I'll give you the score. Five. All right, Party Rock. So this is a 5 score for the pizza. That is right down the middle. Right down the middle means it's a decent pizza. It's not trash. It's not excellent. It's a decent pizza. Coming down from, you know, I've had a Tombstone, which was a good one, and I've had the Freschetta, which is a good one. Those are some good scoring pizzas. I think the Freschetta was a 7.5 and the Tombstone was an 8. So those are some good scoring pizzas. Coming down to a 5 here, the Jack's disappointed me. I did the Jack's original crust, and the Supreme was a 6.5. That was better than this. Though disappointing, it's pretty basic, to be honest. You know, you taste it. It's got a decent amount of sauce, so that's good. But there's just not a lot of flavor. I mean, they have all the ingredients. They got the crust. It looks good. The cheeses melt together. The 2 doses of pepperoni. It looks really appeasing. You know, here's a word for you. Aesthetics. What does something look like? The pizza looks aesthetically pleasing. But there's just not a great taste to it. It's not a signature taste. We're like, I'm going to remember that pizza. Just very run-of-the-mill, very basic type of pizza. Kind of like the name of the brand here, Jack. Pretty basic name. I mean, my name's Zach. It's a basic name as well. But basic pizza right here. Basic pizza. Not the greatest. A little disappointed here in Mr. Jack. Free time here. Also put together a bit of a kind of chart hierarchy of these pizzas as I reviewed them. You guys can take a look at that here. So these are the pizzas I reviewed. Remember that Totino's is just terrible. Red Baron Breakfast, not very good as well. DiGiorno Thin and Crispy, not good. Aldi one, decent range. Just Jack's I'd throw in there with a 5. Being a decent pizza. You know, the thin crust Jack's is better. Tombstone. The 5 cheese, pretty solid, but mixed with some hot sauce and it's better. Freschetta is pretty good. The Totino's pizza rolls are really good. Did some other foods there. Some ice cream, pork ribs. Pork ribs always good. Hot pockets are pretty much always good. So these are the reviews we've done so far. You know, I guess I could throw a little hot sauce on here. See if that improves our score for the old Jack's. See if this bumps it up from a 5 with some hot sauce. Nope. Doesn't help it at all. This is just, it's a basic pizza. Not a good flavor to it. Disappointing. I'm going to be disappointed in you, Jack's. Disappointed in you. Hoping we'll get some better ones in the future here. I know Tony's Pizza's coming up. Probably going to try to do a Casey's Breakfast Pizza as well. I know I had that stuff before and it's excellent. We're going to do a live review on that. So it's coming down the pipe. We're going to go to the store and just see kind of what else we can find in the future here as well. Had a request for Aroma. So that'll be coming if I can find it as well. You never know what you're going to find at the store these days. Whole quarantine situation, people just stock up on stuff. So we'll see. But Jack's, bit of a disappointing pizza. You know, it's still, I'm going to eat this pizza because a pizza day keeps the corona away. But Jack's, you let me down. I'm sorry, Ryan, if you're watching this out there. But there's better pizzas out there, man. Jack's, it's not where it's at, even if it takes you down memory lane.